Hello guys, welcome to Tech Mode. And in this tutorial we are going to cover about what is WebDriver exceptions in a two-part series, and this is the past one. And this series is basically focuses primarily on the QA interview questions and how Selenium WebDriver exceptions works and what are those. So let's get started. So first we have to understand what is exception actually. So exception, if anyone ask you about it, so it's a basically kind of a problem that occurs during the execution of a program. So suppose we have written a certain program, and there are some kind of exception occurs, then basically what exception does is that it basically stops the execution of program. So suppose if we don't want to stop that, suppose there is an exception and we don't want to stop the exception, we just want to catch it and we wanted to do is something else to it, so then you have to catch the exception, right? So as you can see in the screen, there's an example where it's a Java example. We have an integer a 99, and what we are doing is that we are basically going to divide it by 0. So probably you have noticed or already know about it that if we divide any number with a 0, it's going to be infinite, and in the programming world it's an exception. It's a basically kind of an arithmetic exception. So similarly, we have WebDriver exceptions whenever we are running our test cases in with a Selenium. So these are the seven types of Selenium WebDriver exceptions generally occurs, and we will going to cover them one by one with the demo parts. All right. So the first one is a no such element exception. It's a kind of a exception occurs whenever certain kind of locators path that we have mentioned are not able to find on the web page. For example, you have a web page where we have an ID of ABC, and you have written a program in your Selenium where you have written, as you can see in the screen, that you have created an instance of a Chrome driver and you are getting a URL, and after that you entered a find element with the path X path. Suppose the XYZ path is invalid or doesn't exist, then we are going to get a no such element exception. So let's go to the example here. Here we have an example of invalid exception. Okay. So as you can see, what we are doing is that we have created a one instance of WebDriver, and we are going a demo app, and we basically going to find an element which has invalid ID. So if we run this program right now, we'll get a no such element exception, and our program will stop executing it. So this is the first exception that we have encountered, is no such element exception. So to handle it, what we have done is that we have entered this code into a try, and we are going to catch it into a catch block, no such element exception. And if we wanted to, after a certain execution, we wanted to do it, we can write some code here after catching the exception. And after that, we have quit the session. So, all right. So if you wanted to see it running, let me run it right now. So basically going to that new tools.demo8 app, and here we have unable to locate the element, and we have an exception of no such element exception. All right. Okay. So let's come to the second exception. It's element not visible exception. So generally what happens is that suppose you have entered, similarly you have execution of a program in Selenium, and the locator that you are trying to find doesn't exist or has an invalid ID, or probably it's not visible right now. It's probably, you can say, it's a hidden. Generally, buttons with some kind of hidden value form, hidden values, certain kind of things occur. So let me go give an example here. So this is a demo website, qa.scrolltest.com, and we have one element h button which has a value hidden. So if we try to execute this, find element by element, and with the h button right now, we will get one exception, which will be this one, element not visible right now, because it's not visible actually on the page. It's a hidden one, and we are trying to find it, and Selenium basically going to give you an exception for it. All right. Okay, third one, the most important one actually, we call it no such a frame exception. So what are the frames actually? If you go to this website qa.scrolltest.com, as you can see, this is a one frame. Let me give you here. So we have one iframe with iframe one ID, and we have iframe two similarly with the py.scrolltest.com, similarly with certain width and elements. So there are two frames, and these two frames also contain certain elements within it, right? So suppose you wanted to click this element, we have exception of no such a frame exception. So suppose we wanted to switch to second element, second of this iframe, then we have to definitely going to provide the ID of ID 2. But suppose if we entered driver.switch2.frame here with invalid XYZ, we are going to get an exception of no such a frame exception on the page, right? So as you can see in this here also, no such a frame exception where driver occurs when the driver in the Selenium product is unable to find the program on the web page to switch, and when driver is switching on the invalid or non-existing frames. So this is kind of a simpler meaning, and as whatever the name said with the exception, it's kind of a similar behavior. All right. Similarly, we have a no alert present exception. Similarly, what happened is that no alert basically kind of a pop-up, if you have seen it somewhere, if you go to this website, if you click on it, so it's alert, right? Hello is alert. Here, what happens is that suppose you have written a code. Alert generally provides certain kind of information to the users. Hello, it's not a useful information, but certain kind of information sometimes. So no alert present exception generally occurs when driver in Selenium code is unable to find the alert of the page to switch. For example, you have to click certain button, right? And after that you have to switch it. Suppose you commented out the part where you have to click the button, and you directly go to driver to switch to alert. So we'll get an exception of no alert present exception right now. All right. So that's all. Here's a sweet potato with love to you. And we are in the next tutorial. We are going to cover our three remaining major exceptions: no such a window session, no started and sale element. These are most important one. Most of the interview questions come from it. Do watch the part two, and see you in the part two. And if you have any suggestion, just go to the comment section and do certain kind of things. After potato, we have one question for you right now as an assignment. So suppose you have a certain 1000 number of test cases right now with your certain requirements. How you are going to reduce the number of test cases? What are the techniques that you are going to do? Comment down in the section below, and I will be definitely going to answer into the part 2. Alright, thanks a lot guys, and see you in the next one.